David National Singh Maharaj 跟我们讲今天的早课，敬请聆听 Hare Krishna。
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadata Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So we're reading the Brihad Bhagavatamrita and we're hearing about a cowherd boy from Govardhan named Gop Kumar who was given a mantra by his guru, and by the power of the mantra, he could travel beyond the universe into the land of liberation.
We heard about the Bhagavatam
So, in this land of liberation, he met first of all with Lord Shiva, along with his Lord Shiva's associates.
在解脱之地，格帕库马尔遇到了主 Shiva 和他的同游们。
And while he was talking to Lord Shiva.Then a group of people came from faraway place who were all associates of the Supreme Lord. They were residents of the Vaikuntha world, and they all had four arms.
Gopa Kumar 和主 Shiva 交谈的时候呢，从遥远的地方来了一群人，他们都是至尊主的同游。他们是外昆塔世界的居民们，他们都长着四臂。
So these associates, these people from the spiritual world, from Vaikuntha, they were all engaged in Sankirtan. They were all chanting the holy names of the Lord, and they were all in great spiritual bliss.
这些来自于灵性世界。白昆特的人们，他们都在做着 Sankirtan， 唱诵着主的圣名，他们沉浸在灵性的喜乐中。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they spoke to Gop Kumar and to Lord Shiva, and they told him that we count you among the Lord's devotees.
这些来昆特的居民们就和贡哈库马尔以及主师傅讲话，他们说道：“我们把你们算在主的奉献者当中。”
Then not only Lord Shiva, but also this cowherd boy, this Gop Kumar, who was the son of a cowherd. They told him, "You are also among the Lord's devotees. That's why we've come here to meet you."
不仅仅他们告诉主 Shiva 这件事儿，还对Govardhan山的牧牛郎的儿子 Gopa Kumar 说：“我们也把你算在主的奉献者，算作主的奉献者，所以来到这里来去见你们，会见你们。”
So the people from Vaikuntha assured Gopa Kumar that he was also ready and qualified to enter into Vaikuntha.
这些 Vaikuntha 的人们呢，就对 Gopa Kumar 说道：“现在呢，已经做好了准备，有资格能够进入到无忧星宿了。”
Yeah, people who properly worship the Vishnu mantra they become pure Vaishnavas, and pure Vaishnavas are qualified to go to Vaikuntha.
那些只要是正确的崇拜了 Vishnu mantra， 就变成了纯净的 Vaishnava， 他们就有资格来进入 Vaikuntha。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they told Gop Kumar that there's a person born in the country of Gora on the bank of the Ganga, and he's a first class Mathura Brahmana.
他们这些外昆达的居民们到对勾华库马尔说，有一个人他出生在勾拉，在恒河岸边，他是一位一流的 Vaishnava， 一流的 婆罗门。
And they told him this Brahmana's name is Jayanta, and he's an incarnation of Krishna, and he is your exalted spiritual master.
他们说，这个人婆罗门名字叫 Jayanta， 他是主 Krishna 的化身，是你崇高的灵性导师。
So the people from Vaikuntha told Gop Kumar, you should accept this as true, and we have come here only for your sake.
Vaikuntha的人们对勾帕库马尔说道，你一定要把我们所说的话接受为是真理，我们是特地为了你来到这里。
And we want to tell you what is actually beneficial for you to do.
我们特地来告诉你什么对你最好。
You should give up everything and with pure love practice the 9 forms of devotional service.
您当放弃一切，怀着纯粹的爱。 来去履行九项奉献服务。 So
when these people from Vaikuntha told Gop Kumar that he should give up everything, they meant that he should be ready to leave this place which he was in. He was in this place called Mahakalapura, place of liberation.
当Vaikuntha的人们 对，勾纳库马尔说，他应当放弃一切的时候，意思是说，他应当做好准备，离开他现在所在的地方，这个名字叫 Mahakalapura 的解脱之地。Right,
the place in Mahakalapura, this is the place where the impersonalists go. Those people who practice the impersonal path, they achieve liberation in this place called Mahakalapura.
这个地方是那些非人格主义者，踏上非人格主义道路的，想要达到解脱的人们，他们会来到这个 Mahakalapura.
And their indication, the people from Vaikuntha are telling Gop Kumar that he should not be attached to chanting his mantra formally.
嗯，Vaikuntha的居民们。 也暗示勾帕库马尔，他不应当依附于正式的去念诵他的 mantra.
Gop Kumar had been chanting out of duty. He thought Guru told him to do it, he should do it. So he was chanting out of a sense of duty. But the people from Vaikuntha want him to experience more ecstatic chanting of the mantra.
勾帕库马尔是出于职责，他的guru呢告诉他，应当去念诵 mantra， 所以他是出于一种职责感、义务感去念诵的。而Vaikuntha的居民们暗示他应当是去体验这个唱诵带来的狂喜。Yeah,
the people from Vaikuntha want Gopkumar to take part in Nam Sankirtan. And to be enthusiastic, to express his love for Lord Krishna
Vaikuntha 的居民们希望 Gopal Kumar 参与到 Nam Sankirtan 其颂圣名当中，能热情地去表达他们对 Krishna 的爱。
And he should take part in all the 9 different methods of pure devotional service.
Gopal Kumar 也应当去参与九项纯粹奉献服务的方法。
So the people from Vaikuntha tell Gop Kumar, you should honor the Bhagavatam and other scriptures that talk about devotional service.
Vaikuntha 的居民们对 Gopal Kumar 说，你应当去荣耀圣典博迦瓦坛以及奉献服务的其他经典。
And you should hear from these scriptures regularly, everything about the Lord's pastimes.
你应当有规律地聆听这些经典，聆听主的种种逍遥时光。
And when these pastimes enter into the holes of your ears, you will relish them with love.
当这些逍遥时光进入到你的耳孔的时候，你就能够品味到爱了。
By hearing them, you'll be able to enter into the Lord's abode.
通过这样的聆听，你就能够进入到主的居所。
So Gop Kumar was a cowherd boy from Govardhan, but he was not educated, and he'd never heard about the 9 methods of devotional service.
戈帕库尔是戈尔丹山的一个男孩子，他没有受过教育，从来没有听说过奉献服务的九项方式。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they tell Gop Kumar first, there's the method of hearing, Shravana.
Vaikuntha 的人们告诉戈帕库尔，首先有聆听，也就是 Shravana 的方法。
And of all the different kinds of hearing about the pastimes of the Lord from Srimad Bhagavatam is recommended. It's the most effective.
在种种不同的聆听当中，聆听圣典博迦瓦坛讲述的逍遥时光是首先得到推荐的，他应当有规律的去聆听。
And Srimad Bhagavatam,
这个方法非常有效果。
Srimad Bhagavatam also recommends this kind of hearing.
圣典博迦瓦坛也推荐了这一类的聆听。
Srimad Bhagavatam says, if a person is suffering in the fire of countless miseries, but if he desires to cross the ocean of material existence,then there's no better boat than cultivating devotion for the Lord by hearing about his pastimes.
经典是这样说的，那些遭受着那些在痛苦的烈焰当中遭受着无数痛苦的人们，他们在物质存在之阳饱尝痛苦，他没对这些人而言，没有比圣典博迦瓦坛更好的一艘船，能够这样他们可以培养通过聆听主的逍遥时光，他们可以培养起对主的奉爱之情。
People should, the Srimad Bhagavatam also says that, but if someone will drink by hearing.The message of the Lord, if he will hear, fill his ears with the sound vibrations about the message of the Lord, then they'll purify themselves of about the aim of life.
圣典博迦瓦坛还说，谁要是通过聆听主的逍遥时，主的讯息，喝饮这个讯息，他们通过他们的耳孔接收到音震，这样的人就能够得到净化， 净化掉他们对生命目标的错误概念。
And they'll give up the idea of material enjoyment, and they'll take shelter of the Lord's lotus feet and go back to Godhead.
他们可以放弃物质享乐的错误概念，脱离主的莲花足，从而回归神手。
So to do devotional service in any one of the nine forms is the best discipline which can help us to go back to the spiritual world, Vaikuntha.
从事于奉献服务的九项方式是最好的最好的规范，可以帮助一个人回归灵性世界，回归无忧心素。
Pure devotional service is superior to all other spiritual practices like karma and jnana.
纯粹的奉爱高于任何灵性的灵修之途，例如karma 和果报和思辨之途。
The benefit of devotional service is much more than you can get from any kind of material enjoyment or liberation.
从物质从奉献服务当中获得的好处远远胜过物质的享乐或者是解脱带来的好处。
No other method can equal the process of devotional service.
再没有哪种方式能和奉献服务的方式相媲美。
We can say the fruit matches with the quality of the tree.
有句谚语是说，这个树上结的果实是和这个树的品质，叫观其树，知其果。什么样的树就会结出什么样的果实。
So people who are initiated into the chanting of Krishna's names, they will certainly get liberation.
得到启迪，从而唱诵主 Krishna 圣名的人，一定能获得解脱。
But if people constantly worship Lord Krishna with pure devotion, then they'll get more.
只要是恒常的怀着纯粹的奉爱崇拜主 Krishna, 这样的人他们得到的好处就更大。
Even people who always remember the Lord in the heart, even if they have dishonest intentions, then when they leave their body, they'll go to the spiritual world.
那些总是把主在记在心中的人，即便他们怀着不诚实的意图，在离开躯体的时候，也能回到灵性世界。
Any other benefit which you may get, which may be talked about in the scriptures, is very great. The people who are actually advanced, they will consider any other benefit other than devotional service to be insignificant.
了不起的好处，但是谁要是进步的人士，会认为除了奉献服务之外，没有什么别的好处了。
So the Vedic scriptures are like a desire tree, and they can grant whatever benefit people want.
维达经就好比如愿树， 可以实现人们所想要的任何好处。
Some people are less fortunate, and they do not appreciate the value of the spiritual world.
不幸的人们，他们不会欣赏到灵性世界的价值。
So they may wish, they may go to the Vedas to get their goal is to get something which is much less than devotional service.
有的人会去接近韦达经，他们的目标，他是在除了奉献服务之外的其他次要的目标。
So whatever they want, they go there, they can get it from the Vedic teachings.
无论他们想要什么，都可以去从韦达经的教导当中去得到他们想要的。
But the intelligent people, those who are really great souls, they know what is important and what is useless.
有智慧的伟大灵魂会知道哪些是重要的，哪些是没有用的。
And they're not attracted by inferior things of the material world which the Vedas may offer.
他们会被伟达经所提供的物质世界的低等事物所吸引。
The great souls, they're only attracted to the transcendental devotional service of the Lord.
伟大的灵魂只会被为主从事超然的奉献服务所吸引。
So devotees who understand the pleasure of devotional service, they will practice all 9 forms of bhakti.
明白奉献服务快乐的奉献者会修习所有9项奉献服务的方法。
So they easily taste the sweetness of the service which they're engaging in.
他们会很容易的就品尝到他们从事的奉献服务带来的甘美。So
devotees can go to Vaikuntha by any one of the 9 kinds of devotional service.
奉献者通过9项奉献服务中的任何一项都可以真达Vaikuntha。But
these devotees, they often like to do all the 9 different kinds to enjoy the taste, the pleasure of these different activities.
但是奉献者们喜欢去享受到去喜欢去品尝到这9项奉献服务所带来的快乐，品尝这些种种的不同活动。
And each of the practices, beginning with hearing and chanting, gives a sweet satisfaction to the devotee.
聆听和唱诵的方法可以给奉献者们带来这种甜美的滋味。
If somebody engages in service to Krishna with faith in any one of these forms, then pure love for the lotus feet of Krishna will come automatically.
怀着信心对主 Krishna 从事这九种奉献服务的形式的人，会自动的就品尝到对 Krishna 纯爱的甘露。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained to Sanatana Goswami what is the meaning of actual faith.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 向 Sanatana Goswami 解释了信心的含义。
And he explains that faith means to trust in the power of devotional service.
他解释说信心就是相信奉献服务的力量。
Yeah, which a devotee understands that simply by serving Krishna, one is performing all important, all activities. Simply by service to Krishna, everything is being done.
他说，奉献者仅仅通过服务 Krishna 就从事了一切的活动了。
So this kind of firm convictions, firm faith, this is very favorable to devotional service.
这种坚定的信心是十分有利于奉献服务。
But still, sometimes there will be some disease which may stop people from desiring to actually go to the spiritual world.
但是有的时候，就是有些疾病会停止人们渴望去灵性世界。
People develop desires for some other goal.
人们发展出其他的欲望。
So a devotee has to keep his heart pure, and he should try not to fall into that problem of thinking something else is more important than devotional service.
所以人们奉献者他们应该让内心纯净，不要让自己陷入这样的问题，认为还有什么比奉献服务更重要。
If we want to develop pure love for Krishna, we should not have any desire for material benefit.
如果我们培养出对 Krishna 的纯爱，就不应该去渴求物质好处。
Material desires will burn in our heart, and it will stop us from having pure love for Krishna.
物质的欲望，会在我们内心焚如烈火，阻碍了我们培养对 Krishna 的纯爱。
So we want to get Krishna prem, we have to get rid of these material desires.
我们如果想要获得 Krishna Prem, 就要做好准备放弃这些物质欲望。
Because if we get diverted, if we think something else is important, then it will stop us from going to the spiritual world.
如果我们中途分心，有别的想法，就会阻止我们去灵性世界。
So material desires bring misfortune, brings inauspiciousness in this world.
物质欲望会让人们会给这个世界上的世人带来不幸和不吉祥。
And it's an obstruction to going back to Godhead.
它是对在我们回归神守路途上的一个障碍。
But once we've developed prema, then these desires will go away.
一旦我们培养出 prema, 这些其他的欲望也就会自动消除了。
And the devotee will know only happiness in this life and in the next, perfect happiness.
奉献者无论在此生还是来世，他们只知道完美的快乐。
Wherever a person is engaged in devotional service, then certainly the Supreme Lord will appear there.
哪里有从事奉献服的奉献者，那主就会显现在哪里。
And that place is as good as Vaikuntha.
那个地方就和 Vaikuntha 一样好。
But still, a devotee should have a special regard for the spiritual world.
奉献者仍然应当特别的尊重灵性世界。
Because it's only in the spiritual world that the personality of Godhead is always directly there and can see him.
因为在灵性世界，人们总是能够直接的见到至尊主，直接的亲眼见到至尊主。
So Sanatana Goswami, the author, he raises a question.
本书的作者 Sanatana Goswami 提出了一个问题。
So he said, since pure love for Krishna looks down on the happiness of Brahman.
他说，对 Krishna 的纯粹之爱会蔑视，Brahman.
And pure love of Krishna includes all kinds of varieties of ecstasy, and is available here in this world.
对 Krishna 的纯洁之爱包含了各种各样的狂喜，而且在这个世上也能够品尝到。
So it doesn't seem like there's any need to go anywhere else. We can just stay here.
所以看上去没有必要去任何其他的地方，我们待在这里就好了。
Even Lord Krishna himself says in the Padma Purana, he says that he can be found wherever the devotee remembers him.
甚至在莲花往事书中，主 Krishna 亲口说，奉献者哪里有思念他的奉献者，就哪里就可以找到 Krishna。
Yeah, there's a famous verse. Naham tishtani vaikunte yoginam ridayeshuva tatra tishtani narada yatra gayanti madbhakta.Krishna said, I do not live in Vaikuntha, and I'm not in the hearts of the yogis.
Krishna 说，我不住在 Vaikuntha 无忧星宿，我也不在那些瑜伽师的心中。
He said, I stay wherever my devotees like Narada are singing my glories.
我待在，像 Narada 这样的我的奉献者荣耀我的地方。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they're pointing out that there is one reason why Vaikuntha is so desirable for devotees more than the spiritual world.
Somehow, I didn't catch the meaning.
Vaikuntha people are telling to Gop Kumar that there is one good reason why Vaikuntha is a better place. It's more suitable for devotees than the material world.
Oh, so Vaikuntha 的居民们就告诉 Gop Kumar 说，有一个原因。就揭示出为什么说，对于奉献者来说，无忧星宿更，比起物质世界而言呢，是更好的地方。
Oh, only in the spiritual world is the Lord always visible with his beautiful pastimes and his wonderful qualities.
只有在灵性世界才可以亲眼见到主，目睹主奇妙的消逝光和品质。
Nowhere else can that kind of devotion to him be understood.
在其他的地方都不能够去明白理解对主的这种奉爱。
Yeah, only in the spiritual world can the devotees worship Krishna without disturbance and in the company of so many surrendered devotees.
只有在灵性世界，那些崇拜主的奉献者们才能够不受干扰的去怀着奉爱去崇拜主。
So we should understand that the devotional service which is rendered in Vaikuntha in the spiritual world is not mixed with any kind of material desire.
所以在维昆塔灵性世界对主所做出的奉献服务不掺杂任何物质欲望。
And it's the only motivation for rendering that service there is pure love for Krishna.
但在那里为主所从事纯粹奉爱服务的动机只有为主所做的服务的唯一的动机就是纯粹的爱。
Yeah, in Vaikuntha, there's none, no frustration because of the time and because of the different physical limitations.
因为昆塔 there is no frustration because of the time and the different limitations.
Yeah, in the material world, we're always disturbed by time. We're always affected by the time and by the different things which are maybe beyond our powers to do. In the material world, we're very limited what we can do, but in the spiritual world, there's none of these problems.
在物质世界呢，我们会受到时间的干扰，会受到超自然力量这些事物的限制，但是在灵性世界就没有这样的问题，就不会这些问就不会有上述与因素给我们带来的挫败感。
And the Vaishnavas who live there all have spiritual bodies, and they enjoy the rasa or the taste of love of Krishna.
而在灵性世界的居民们都是有着灵性的身体，他们在享受着 rasa， 他们享受的 rasa。享受着对主的奉爱的甘滋味。
And the freedom which they enjoy there, they cannot get that kind of freedom anywhere else.
他们在那里所享受的自由自在是在任何其他地方享受不到的。
All the Vaishnavas therefore should give Vaikuntha the honor it deserves.
因此，所有的外师那把都应当给予外昆塔恰如其分的尊敬之情。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they tell Gopkumar. He said, they tell him, don't think that devotional service is just an activity of the body.And the senses and the mind.
Vaikuntha 的居民们告诉 Gopkumar， 不要以为奉献服务仅仅是身体、感官和心意的活动。
No, it's the eternal absolute reality.
它是永恒的、绝对的真相。
And it's the most intense ecstasy beyond the material nature.
它是在超越了物质自然形态之上的最最强烈的狂喜。
So the people from Vaikuntha, they had asked Gop Kumar to do devotional service.
Vaikuntha 的人们便请求 Gop Kumar 从事奉献服务。
But they don't want Gop Kumar to think that this devotional service is just a ritual which people do.
他们不希望 Gop Kumar 认为就像别的人那样认为奉献服务仅仅是一种仪式。
Don't think that devotional service is just some kind of human endeavor.
不要认为奉献服务只是一种俗人所做的努力。
So the people from Vaikuntha are explaining to Gop Kumar that bhakti,Pure bhakti is never approached by the material senses.
Vaikuntha 的人们就向 Gop Kumar 解释说，纯粹的 bhakti 奉爱，不是用这种世俗的感官可以去达到的。
Now, hearing of course is done with the ears.And chanting with the tongue and remembering with the mind.
聆听是通过耳朵，来从事的，而念诵是舌头所从事的活动，而意念是心意所做的活动。
And praying and other activities with the body. These activities.Are not material. These are also spiritual activities.
祈祷和其他的活动，是通过身体所从事的，但是这些活动并不是物质的活动，它们是灵性的活动。
These activities can only be done by devotees with awakened spiritual senses.
只有那些已经唤醒了灵性感官的奉献者才能够从事这些奉献服务。
So it's only by Krishna's mercy that the devotees are able to realize devotional service in many varieties.
只有凭藉 Krishna 的仁慈奉献者们才能够觉悟到各式各样的奉献服务。
And this will show itself and it will be revealed to them in their hearts.
而这些将会在奉献者的内心被揭示给他们。
But their hearts have to be free from material modes.
但是他们的内心必须要摆脱了物质自然形态的污染。
And they should be full of eternity knowledge and bliss.
他们应当是充满着永恒知识和极乐。
So we may ask,Well, if devotional service can be performed only with spiritual senses, how can conditioned souls like herself ever qualify to do it?
我们可能会提出疑惑，既然奉献服务是灵性感官的活动，我们这些受条件限制的灵魂又能如何有资格能够从事奉献服务呢？
So we should understand that the senses can be purified enough to begin about hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord. We can do this only by Krishna's causeless mercy. And as the devotee becomes more expert in his practice, then the devotee's taste will gradually appear. He will develop more taste for different services.
随着奉献者在奉献服务当中变得越来越精到，他们也便能够品尝到这不同的奉献服务的甘美。
And when they come to higher levels of advancement, they will reciprocate with Krishna with more ecstasy. They'll have more ecstasy in reciprocation with Krishna.
随着奉献者他的层面越来越高，越来越进步，他就能够怀着越来越多的狂喜之情回应Krishna。
And when a devotee becomes completely, when he's able to discriminate completely, then the devotee will become pure in heart.
当奉献者能，他的辨别力越来越趋于完善的时候，他的内心也变越来越纯净。
And then he will go to the abode of the Lord.
随后他便能够去主的居所。
And there he will understand, he will realize the all the wonderful variety of devotional service.
在那里他便能够觉悟到各式各样的奉献服务。
So Sanatana Goswami is telling us how a devotee can become spiritualized.
Sanatana Goswami 告诉我们，奉献者如何能变得越来越灵性化。
Simply by hearing and being able to distinguish between spirit from matter, the devotee gradually frees his consciousness from the material energy.
仅仅通过聆听，并且区分辨物质和灵性的二者的区别，奉献者便能让他的知觉摆脱物质能量的掣肘。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also describes about this kind of discrimination to Arjuna. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, one becomes aware that the senses are simply interacting with their objects.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主Krishna说，一旦我们意识到感官和感官对象在搅在一起的时候，
And when one gets free from all material contact, then one can enter Vaikuntha.
当一旦人们摆脱了所有对物质的接触，就能够 就进入到了昆塔了。
And of course, in Vaikuntha, there will be no connection with matter.
当然，在Vaikuntha，那里和物质是没有任何的联系的。
In Vaikuntha, one can enjoy the real nectar, the real variety of life.
在外昆塔，人们便能够得享真正的甘露，得享丰盛的生活。
But if somebody else, someone else's heart may be freed from all material endeavors as a result of transcendental knowledge, he's detached himself from all material endeavors.
一旦人们的内心拥有了超人的知识，他们就能够不依附各种各样的物质的努力。
The material endeavors are done with the body and the senses and the mind.
物质的努力呢是透过身体、感官和心意做的。
So by transcendental knowledge, someone a person may be able to give up these endeavors.
透过超然的知识，一个人便可以放弃这种种种的物质努力。
So for that person, the activities of devotional service would just be like ordinary affairs.
对于这些物质主义者，奉献服务的活动呢，看上去好像是普通的事情。
So someone may say, if devotional service is made up of actions of the material senses upon material objects, then it's not spiritual. It's just the same as any other activity.
有人可能会反驳说，如果奉献服务也是用物质的，也是物质的感官作用于物质的对象上面的活动，那么这个奉灵，这些活动呢，就和别的活动没有什么区分了。
And a person who is a person who has purified himself, who has given up material activities, he wouldn't want to do it. He wouldn't want to engage in these kind of activities.
谁要是已经净化了自身，并且放弃了种种物质的活动的话，他就也不想要从事这种活动。
So after getting free of all these Vedic duties, why will he want to accept new activities which will just give him more karma?
既然他们已经摆脱了种种的伟大仪式，为什么还要接受这些新的活动，让自己承担更多的业报呢？
Yeah, the advanced soul would judge the activities of Vaishnavas unfavorably. You'd think these Vaishnavas are just engaging in material activities.
表面上进步的灵魂会评判 Vaishnava 的活动，认为他们也是物质的活动。
And he would think that, oh, their senses are involved with their objects. So they're performing material activities and they will get karma for it.
他们会说，你看这些人的感官也是，作用于感官对象上面，从而是一种物质的活动，并这样呢，就会招致这个业报反应。
So this is the thinking of these jnanis, these people who are not devotees.
就是那些 jnani, 思辨家的思维模式, 他们不是奉献者。
So why should somebody who's given up all the activities of devotion to the Lord go to Vaikuntha?
Why should somebody...
Someone who's stopped, who's given up devotional service, they're not doing devotional service. So why should he go to the Lord? Why should he go to the spiritual world? No need.
倘若某人已经放弃了对主的奉献服务，那么他为什么还要去主那里去灵性世界呢？没有必要了。
He will think the activities of the spiritual world are also material.
他们会误以为灵性世界的活动也是物质的活动罢了。So
these kind of people, they can get only liberation. Impersonal liberation.
这类人呢, 他们只能够获得非人格的解脱。
So impersonalists, they think devotional activity to be material.
非人格主义者认为
So these impersonalists, they don't even have one drop of the mercy of devotional service. They're trying to get relief from attachment to the results of material work. So they can have liberation, but without bhakti, they can never enter Vaikuntha.
他们可以获得达到解脱，但是没有bhakti奉爱是进入不了Vaikuntha的。To
go to Vaikuntha, you must be favored with the blessings of devotion.
谁要是想进入Vaikuntha，必须得到奉爱的祝福的仁慈。
So in this way, we understand the spiritual nature of devotional service. All right, we'll stop here today.
Okay, 奉爱服务中应该以职责去取悦，还是体验自己内在的狂喜更好呢？ In devotional service, should we try to please out of duty, or should we try to experience internal bliss, which is better?
You should try to serve Krishna out of spontaneous love for Krishna.
You want to do devotional service,
the mood should be to please Krishna.
您要是想从事奉献服务，那么您的心态应当是去取悦 Krishna。 向至尊祈祷没有得到故人准许起作用吗？He continued to ask, if we pray to the Supreme Lord without the sanction of Guru, will that prayer be effective?
Well, without the sanction of the Guru, you're praying to the Lord. Well, you can try.
Yeah.
It depends what you're praying for. Why would you do something without the sanction of the Lord?
没有得到主的允许，就做一件事呢？He said, without the sanction of Guru.
Without the sanction of the Guru, yes. Well, to try to approach to the Lord without the sanction of the Guru, it will be very difficult.
倘若没有Guru的准许，去努力接近主，这是很难，很艰难的。
You're going to try to go to the Guru, go to God without the Guru. Nobody's introducing you. Lord Krishna won't give you much attention because Lord Krishna said you have to worship his devotee. You have to go through the devotee.
在没有 Guru 情况下呢，去努力接近神，没有。这样一个没有 Guru 的介绍，那 Krishna 就不会注意你，不会在意你，因为 Krishna 希望人们去崇拜他的奉献者，透过 Guru 来，一定要透过，经过 Guru。
You don't have the introduction to Krishna.
因为没有谁。向 Krishna 介绍你，没有这样的介绍人。
Krishna wants to know that you're respecting his devotees.
Krishna 希望知道你在尊重他的奉献者们。
But you're going to pray to Krishna directly. Well.You can try, but it's not the recommended way.
你想直截了当的去接近神，没有Guru，直接接近神，你可以试一下。But you can try, but
it's not the recommended way.
Oh, okay. 但是这种方法并不是受到推荐的方法，没有得到推荐。
Lord Krishna himself tells us how we should approach him.
Krishna 本人告诉说一个人如何去接近他。
Of course, if you just do it out of spontaneous love, then it might be possible. Just out of spontaneous love for Krishna,You forget about your guru and you just go to, you pray to, oh Krishna, help me. So, in some cases, it may be possible.
你也可以是出于自发的，也就是出于自发的爱这么做的，去祈祷的，这是可能的，就是对，已经对 Krishna 有了自发的爱，所以放弃了 Guru, 你可能祈祷说Krishna, 快帮帮我帮帮我吧。所以在这种情况下是可能的。Bhakti 说Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有奉献者，请问怎样才能得到奉爱的祝福？就 Hare Krishna listens to Guru and all devotees. May I ask, how can I get the blessing of bhakti?
You get the blessings of bhakti by engaging in activities of bhakti, by engaging in chanting and hearing.
您可以通过从事于 bhakti 奉爱的活动, 比如像聆听和唱诵这样的活动, 来得到奉爱的祝福。 下一个问题是 Dakshina 君伟, 敬拜亲爱的 Gurudev 奉献者们, Mahakala Pura 是在 Vaikuntha 吗？
No, it's not in Vaikuntha.
不是，不在了，昆塔。
But it's beyond the material universe.
但是它已经超越了物质的宇宙了。嗯哼。Isha Priya 真真说，顶拜 Guru Maharaj 所有奉献者们，联谊的时候擦地、洗碗、做饭。 所有服务都体验到特别快乐，在家也积极做这些服务，似乎没这种体验，是心态不对吗？没有，是没有这么好的知觉吗？ During association, I mop the floor, clean the, to wash the pots and plates, and to cooking. In every service, I experience, my experience is very happy, but I do the same activity in my house. I don't have this kind of experience. Is that my mentality is not right, or I don't have very good consciousness?
Yes, your mentality is not right, and it also means you don't have very good consciousness.
是的，你的心态不对，也没有很好的知觉。
The consciousness should be that your home is also the temple, Krishna is also there, and you're residing there as a servant of Krishna. So you're cleaning the house, you're washing the pots at home. You're doing it for Krishna.
所以你的心态应当是你的家也是一所庙宇， Krishna 就在你的家里的庙， 你住在那里呢， 只是以仆人的身份住在这里， 所以你清洁和刷锅碗， 而是为了 Krishna 从事这些活动。
So you have to work on your consciousness and control your mind.
所以您当, 在你的知觉上下功夫并且控制心意。
You have to hear and read Prabhupada's books more.
需要更多的聆听，更多的阅读圣帕帕的书籍。
Don't allow your mind to degrade you.
不要允许你的心意让你沉沦堕落。
Krishna is everywhere. Krishna is also in your home.
Krishna 遍凑万有, Krishna 也在你的家中。
Okay.
Okay. 何家权说, 百昆大奉献者和勾巴库尔的对话 是在教导处在非人格主义解脱者及物质世界的思辨者吗？ He's asking whether or not the talking between Vaikuntha devotees and Gopal Kumar is to teach those people who is aiming at the impersonal liberation and the Gyani in the material world.
The purpose of their talking is to teach what? The impersonalists?
To teach those people who want to get impersonal liberation, and to teach those speculator in the material world. He's asking, what's the aim, what's the purpose of the talking? Is it to benefit those impersonalism and gyanis?
Yes, right.
是的，你说的是对的。
And it's to encourage also the young devotees, the neophyte devotees, to fully take up the path of devotional service.
并且是鼓励年轻的奉献者，新的奉献者，全心全意的来从事于来踏上这个奉爱服务的之途。Kirtanananda Devadasi, 顶拜千的 Guru Deva, 没有物质污染，控制心意，躯体到外昆塔。道是活着到达还是死后？顶拜您。控制心意，躯体到外昆塔。没有。Panmukhi Maharaji, 您听得懂这个吗？She's asking, as one is get freed from material pollution, if there is no material contamination, one control his mind and body to reach Vaikuntha. Is that only we can attain Vaikuntha after death, or we can attain Vaikuntha even if we are still living?
Well, you can have Vaikuntha consciousness while you're still living. You can have that kind of consciousness.
你可以就是在活着的时候拥有的是Vaikuntha的知觉。
You have that kind of consciousness, and you can feel yourself to be a devotee of Krishna and to be engaged in his service and to not to be worried about the material energy, to give up material desires. You can have that, the mood of the spiritual world without actually going there.
你可以去感受到自己的身份是 Krishna 的奉献者，你在做着服务，你并没有担心物质能量的影响，而且也放弃了物质的欲望，你的心态是灵性世界的心态，而你自己呢，并没有就是心灵奇境的去了Vaikuntha，就可以达到上述的这种境界。
The difference, however, is that if you actually go there, then you'll actually be able to directly see the Lord there, and you can engage in pastimes with Him.
但是还是有区别的。一旦你去了百昆塔的话，你就能够直接目睹到主在那里的百昆塔的之主。并且从事于参与到他的消失光。
But here, living here in the material world, we can feel the presence of the Lord, but you won't necessarily directly see Him all the time.
在物质世界呢，你可以感受到，你可以感受到主的灵在。 但不一定能够直接的随时 随刻的每时每刻的见到主。何家全说顶麦主的顶麦顾队的莲花组。华为请问生活在物质世界如何不接触物质世界呢？物质事物。Guru, how can I live in the material world but still I don't get touch with material objects?
Well, we have to think how to use everything in the service of Krishna.
所以我们应当去思考如何利用一切，把一切又都用来服务 Krishna。
If you have the consciousness it's all Krishna's energy and it's meant for Krishna's pleasure, then won't be a problem.
如果你的知你有拥有这种知觉，就是看待一切都是 Krishna 的能量，一切都本来应该是用来来去取悦 Krishna， 让 Krishna 高兴的话，就不存在这样的问题了。Dakshina 的问题已经回答了。Yoga Lakshmi Sir 对 Dasi， 另外 Gurudev 和所有奉献者，请问，那翻译，请问三月一日节日怎样庆祝是合适的？第一次庆祝150周年，巴基斯坦的萨萨提的那个庆典，请您给予指导。She's asking, This is the first time we celebrate the 150th anniversary of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur on March 1st. So can you give us guidance how to do the celebration?
Well, generally the system is we will put a picture of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada.On a Vyasa San, and you can also take Prabhupada's picture off the Vyasa San and put Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati there, and put Prabhupada on a position lower than Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, and then we offer Guru Puja to the picture, and then we offer flowers, and we offer prasadam.
一般呢是就是把帕帕德的照片从维阿萨山那拿下来，把圣巴蒂斯丹塔萨尔萨塔库帕帕帕德的照片放在这个维阿萨座位上，把圣帕帕德的照片放在比巴蒂斯丹萨塔库的照片低一点的位置上，然后向着巴蒂斯丹萨塔库的照片做咕噜咕噜抛鲜花，还有给他供奉和杀的。
And we should also explain and talk about the activities of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, all the preaching and all the propaganda work which he did to establish the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
我们也要解释圣巴提斯丹塔萨拉萨萨塔库的活动，他所做的所有的传播活动，他做的这些宣传工作，他建立了主柴丹娘马帕布的使命。The next one?
Yeah.
Halabati Radha Dasi 说 Hare Krishna 的乃 Guru 翻译和所有奉献者。我家梵歌6.16要旨说，随人为进食，自己制定断食程序是修不成瑜伽的。目前有很多人奉行安东尼的食疗法，早上空腹喝柠檬水，喝西芹汁，不吃无油无盐的食物，不吃牛奶和麸质食物。请问 Guru， 这是一种善良形态的饮食，还是愚昧形态的自行安排的饮食呢？身体处于亚健康的人可以遵循这种饮食方式吗？Guru, in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 6, verse 16, purport, who fast artificially to follow the procedure of fast made by oneself cannot attain success in practice of yoga. Nowadays, many people are following the method, Antony's diet. In the early morning, they drink lemon juice empty stomach, and they drink the juice of a kind of xi qin cai. They drink the juice of a vegetable, and they don't eat milk and green food. So may I ask Guru whether it is a kind of a diet in the mood of goodness or ignorance? That they made by themselves, one for one whose body is already in the not healthy condition, can this person follow this kind of a diet?
No, of course, somebody who's not healthy, they'll have difficulty to follow this kind of diet, I think. Anyway, this is a health consideration. Somebody is following this kind of diet. They must have some health, particular health motivations by their doing it.
就是亚健康的人呢，他们可能就追随不了这种饮食方式了。但是无论是谁，他追随这种饮食方式的话，肯定是有他们自己的健康考虑的。他们动机一定是为了。
But it, I don't think it's spirit. It's not required spiritually.
但是是在灵性。但是，我认为，就是对于灵修是没有这种必要的。
But everyone, according to their needs, they know what their body needs, they know what is suitable for them to eat and what is a suitable diet for them. So it's up to every individual to decide for themselves what kind of diet they want to follow.
但是呢，因为个人的体质不一样，他们需求不同，他们可以选择适合的方式，自己自行决定，去遵循什么样的饮食方式，这是他们的个人的事情。
Kamalamurti,
尊敬的 Guru, 顶戴您，请问在奉爱服务和履行职责时受到阻碍，怎样才能改变这种状态，更好的服务？Dear Guru, may I ask, if I met obstacle when carrying out devotional service and my duty, how can I change the situation and to do better service?
In
the process of devotional service and carrying out the duties, I meet with obstacles. There are obstacles.
Well, there will always be obstacles in everything. We have to expect in everything we do, there will be obstacles coming. But we have to be determined to go on with our devotional service.
我们应当就是期待着预期 就一切事情当中呢都会有障碍，这个应该是在我们的预料之内的。但是呢，我们应当下定决心，无论发生什么事情，都要继续做奉献服务。
You have to be determined to keep going, and gradually the obstacles will be removed. Lord Krishna can help us to overcome all the obstacles.
就是，无论情况如何，我们都应当坚持不懈的走下去。这样呢，我们的这个路上的障碍就能够消除，因为有主 Krishna 在那里帮助我们。
And by the mercy of Guru also, Guru can also help us if we follow the instructions of the spiritual teachers. Then he can remove all the obstacles on the path.
而且有仁慈的Guru帮助我们，有来自灵性导师的训示在那里，所以他们就可以帮助我们。 移除障碍。
We have to have faith in what we're doing, faith in the process. By faith, understand simply by serving Krishna that we're doing everything required, then the obstacles will gradually be removed. If you have that strong faith that what you're doing is right, that it's the proper thing, then these obstacles will gradually disappear.
就是我们应该对我们所做我们的这个程序这个法门有信心，相信，仅仅通过服务 Krishna， 我们就已经做了我们需要我们做的一切，这样的过程当中呢，障碍就能够。 去移除，首先我们要确信我们所做的是正确的事情，我们做的都是对的，慢慢的，这些障碍就消失了。嗯哼。嗯，OK，Thank you。下一个问题是安卓说，哈里克什纳圣帕巴德在书里写过，当他到达美国，看到高科技的世界，感叹。 如果把人们当作对 Krishna 的奉献服务，会是多么好的一件事情？请教 Guru， 我们该如何把物质世界的活动灵性化呢？So when Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada said in the book that when he first arrived in America, he saw the world, Western world, with all the high technology, he is exclaiming that if people took everything, including those high technology, as a devotional service to Lord Krishna, and how it will be a nice thing. So may I ask Guru, how can we change our activities in the material world? Into a spiritual activity, how to spiritualize our activities in the material world?
Simply by dedicating everything for the service of Krishna, for the pleasure of Krishna. And that means offering the results of your work also for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们一切都献出来，把一切都当作是为 Krishna 的快乐而去从事的服务，把我们的工作结果拿出来，供奉给主 Krishna 来取悦主 Krishna。
The devotees know how to change matter to spirit, and the process is simply by using everything material in the service of Krishna.
奉献者们深深的能够悟到把物质灵性化的这个道理。 他们仅仅是运用物质的事物来去服务 Krishna。
嗯哼，
好，那下一个问题是Santa Devadasi, Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儒和奉献者，服务非奉献者，可以心意平和的。当他是 Krishna 的庙宇吗？ So Guru, my question is that when we serve the non-devotees, can we took the body of non-devotees as the temple of Krishna?And in this way, we can peacefully serve the non-devotees.
Yes, Krishna is also in the heart of the non-devotees. Krishna's in everyone's heart. So even someone is not a devotee, if you see Krishna in their heart, you can also serve them. And they can be changed. They can also gradually become devotees.
嗯，就是是的，嗯，因为 Krishna 也在非奉献者的心中呢，他在 Krishna 在每个生物的心中，所以对于非奉献者呢，你也可以看到在他的心中 ，Krishna 住在他们的心中，从而服务他们，这样呢就能慢慢的把他们逐步的改变成为奉献者。
嗯哼。
Kesha Priya said, thank you, Guru Maharaj, I will read more books. And Baba Tarini Devadas 说，顶来孤儒奉献者，请问孤儒，向主祈祷，怎么能不愉悦孤儒？是先向孤儒祈祷，再向主祈祷一遍吗？ Guru, how can we not, how can we pray to the Lord?And not get over to Guru. Should we first of all pray to Guru one time and then we pray to the Lord again?
Yes, okay. You can do that.
是的，您可以这么去做。
Pray to the Guru. First, usually we pray to the Guru and then we pray to Krishna. Yes. We approach Krishna through the spiritual teacher. So you pray first to the Guru and then you pray to Krishna. Yes. We do that.
是的，是的，我们确实是先向孤儒祈祷。然后向奎师那祈祷，我们是这样去做的。
嗯哼。
嗯。查如，那个，看到当时呢，您那个问题，因为我现在翻到这儿不方便，您再发一遍吧，这个问题。下一个是查如玛达维德达西。顶戴孤儒，请问奉献者用非奉献穿过的衣服或电器会有业报吗
？No.
So she said, "No, 没有。J I Stars， 感谢精彩讲课。主不在瓦昆塔，不在瑜伽大师心中，在拿拉达的歌颂中。瓦昆塔居民如朱瓦普拉的大群也在赞美至尊主，为什么主不在瓦昆塔呢
？Well, Krishna is giving an example. He's saying he wants the devotee to be attached to the chanting of the holy name.
就是主 Krishna 他在这里是打了一个比方，他的例子是他这么说。主 Krishna 说，奉献者们应当去依附于唱诵主的圣名。
You may be thinking, oh, I just want to go to Vaikuntha to be with Krishna. But what's important is the chanting of the holy name. So Krishna said, No, I'm not in Vaikuntha. I'm where my devotee is chanting the holy name. So he wants you to chant the holy name. Then you can go to Vaikuntha.
奉献就是，Krishna的重点是说，人们应当唱诵圣名。他说我不在百昆塔，我在奉献者唱诵我的圣名的地方。所以他希望呢，人们应当唱诵圣名之后呢，去百昆塔。人们都想着哦，应该去百昆塔和主在一起。Krishna说，不是，你应当唱诵我的圣名，之后去百昆塔。 下一个是Shruti Rupa Devadasi。亲爱的Guru、老师们，春暖花开，大自然鸟语花香，户外无人管理的花儿摘回来供奉神像，是否是偷呢？Shruti Rupa's first question is that now is springtime and there are flowers everywhere in the mature nature. We pick them and offer to the deity. Is it stealing?
Not if you offer them to Krishna. Everything belongs to Krishna. The flowers are Krishna's creation. They're meant for offering to Krishna.
这个不算偷。 因为一切是属于 Krishna 的，Krishna 就是创造的一切，都应该用来供奉给 Krishna。另外再请教，奉献者之间在成长过程中，是否要注意说话？比如以前很随意开玩笑，现在可能会被误解，打扰其他人。 So Guru, should we also take care of what our speaking? Because previously we'll make joking and carelessly talk with others, but now those same joking will be the cause of misunderstanding. Even to disturb others. So my question is that should we discipline our speaking and to be very strict? What should we say to others?
Yes.
How to use our...
Yes, you should. Just like Rupa Goswami, he's given us instructions, the nectar of instruction. He says one of the problems of falling down, of not advancing in Krishna consciousness, it can be due to prajalpa, nonsense talking things which are not in relation to Krishna consciousness.
是的，您应当注意言语的文字的严谨和规范。圣如果勾萨你在 教诲的甘露当中呢，他说到，就是人们堕落的一个没有在 Krishna 之觉取得进步的一个原因就是 prajapa， 就是闲言碎语、八卦、胡说八道，和说和 Krishna 之觉无关的话。
Yes, we want to be absorbed in Krishna katha, not gramya katha. Gramya katha means the talk of the village. In the village, people will talk so much gossip, but we want to absorb the talking just simply in talks of Krishna.
So we should focus on Krishna, Krishna katha, and not gramya katha. Gramya katha is the village people in the village like gossip. We should focus on Krishna's topic. 下一个问题是 Novel 说，Guru在做 Guru 顶戴 Guru 莲花组做 Guru 铺者是单独给 Guru 供奉食物 还是在神堂供奉，如果给孤儿供奉食物，是给 Krishna 供奉过吗？
Yes, it should be offered to Krishna first.
是的，是的，应该先给 Krishna 供奉过。
And then offer to Guru.
然后再给 Guru 供奉。
Was that the question?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
The question is that should we first offer the food on the altar, then we take the food and offer to Guru?
Yeah.
是的，是就像您说的，先在神堂供奉，然后给 Guru 供奉。Chaitanya Rupa。顶麦咕噜婆婆家人跳楼自杀了，我应不应该建议她的母亲给她做祭祀，还是我不说私下里给她在马普大庙祭祀呢？
Somebody committed suicide?
Yeah, somebody committed suicide from the,
the roof. Jumped off the roof.
Yeah, from the mother-in-law's family.
So we're going to do a ritual for them.
She wants to do the yagya, and she's asking whether she should suggest the mother-in-law to do the yagya, or should we secretly do the yagya in Mapu temple?
Secretly?
Yes.
Well, I'm not sure. Usually, you know, if somebody dies, then usually you don't do the yagya because they've already departed from the body. But what we do, we try to do some, like distribute prasada in their name.Or we distribute some literature in their name. Or you organize a feast for the devotees and you invite all the people to come and take prasadam and you ask them to give blessings for the departed soul.
通常呢，对于已经离世的人是不给他们做，无需做祭祀了，因为他们已经走了。通常是给他们以他们的名义派普沙的，以他们的名义派经典，还有组织大餐，邀请所有的人来荣耀大餐，然后祝福这位已经离世的人。
And if you have their ashes, then you can also have it sent to put in Mother Ganges, which can also purify.
如果有他的骨灰的话，也可以撒在恒河里，这也是有净化的。So we move on.
Yeah.
Hades, 顶拜咕噜，翻译奉献者们，我的问题是，当和非奉献者在一起。即便主题是跟育儿读书相关，是不是也不应该参加这样的活动？有时候我心里很挣扎，觉得这些妈妈闲扯，有时候自己拿不定主意，觉得除了阅读国家放歌，在读书会上关于育儿的部分还是落地和实际的。请问咕噜，我应该如何选择？有时候确实也觉得浪费时间，某些时候偏离主题的读书让我难受。 So she's asking, when I get along with non-devotees, because their topics is related to how to bring up their children.So whether or not I should participate in this kind of activity, I felt very conflict because I felt they are gossip. But sometimes I'm indecisive. I felt except reading Bhagavad Gita, it's all also very practical on this part. So may I ask Guru, what should I do? Because sometimes I feel it's a waste of time.
Well, if you think you can learn something from these people who are not devotees, especially when it comes to dealing with children, then you know they might have some things which are useful, which you may be able to apply. You don't want to spend a lot of time with them. You don't want to become too much attached and absorbed in their affairs. But sometimes it's enough just to read a book by people about children, about how to bring up children and how to take care of children. Maybe you can get some books on it, or you can go on the internet and you can find out things.
如果是话题是有关于育儿方面的呢，你和这些非中年在一起也能有所收获，特别是主题是有关于孩子的，可能是有用的也很实用，但是你不需要花大量的时间，也不需要特别的衣服，一心一意的就把自己陷在里头了，而且呢，您可以上网上查相关的资料，或者是买一本育儿书。 哦，下一个问题 ，Daxina， 礼拜孤独队和甜美翻译，Gopal Kumar的孤独，不是奉献者吗？给他的 mantra， 他只是出于职责而没有去体验生命的狂喜，怎么理解呢？So， the guru of Gopal Kumar， is a devotee， but Gopal Kumar is chanting the mantra out of duty, and Gopal Kumar haven't experienced the ecstasy of life. How to understand this fact?
Well, it takes some time for the mantra to take effect. That Gopal Kumar is realizing more and more the power of the mantra, and he's getting more and more knowledge about the spiritual world. He had to learn these things. He had to learn. It takes some time.
Because first, 就一件事物起作用呢，是需要花时间的，而且Gopal Kumar正在越来越多的觉悟，对这首 mantra 更越来越多的觉悟，他也对灵性世界有了越来越多的觉悟，所以，要学习一件事物是需要时间的。The
guru doesn't reveal everything immediately.
古鲁不会一下子
He's testing Gopal Kumar to see how faithful he is in chanting the mantra.
他在考验Gopal Kumar，他在念诵 mantra，对于念诵 mantra 这件事情上，他到底是有多么的忠心耿耿的念。
Gradually, he's getting more and more realization.
而且，他正在 逐步地获得越来越多的觉悟和领悟。
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Jai Padma, 感谢Guru的精彩讲课。请问圣人和纯粹奉献者的区别是什么?
圣人跟奉献者?
纯粹奉献者。
Oh, 纯粹奉献者。 Pure devotees and saintly persons. Well, 圣人, saintly person. They may be devotees, they may not be devotees. They may be Mayavad, maybe impersonalists. They may be just great sages, just like residents in the higher planet, demigods in the higher planet.
圣人可能是封建者，可能不是封建者，这些圣人可能是马拉比，也可能是非人格主义者，也可能是伟大的圣人，像居住在高等星宿上的伟大圣人和半神人们。下一个问题是Pasanta，对大喜，对麦Guru。 偷花是给Krishna做供，偷青菜可以吗？ We steal vegetable for Krishna.
We steal vegetables.
Yeah, since the stealing flower and offered Krishna, it's okay. What about stealing vegetable and make an offering to Krishna?
Yeah, everything belongs to Krishna. Everything is Krishna's, should be offered to Krishna. But don't get caught. If you get caught stealing, then it's not good.
是的，因为一切都是属于Krishna的，一切都应该供奉给Krishna。 但是你不要被人抓住，那就麻烦了。Guru，小草，顶拜Guru和翻译一起唱诵，容易。 流泪，咕噜扑着，想起咕噜训示也流泪，连一听课经常流泪，好是不好呢？
Well,
she said,
it's not very helpful for your devotional service.
这对您的奉献服务，并不是很有注意的。
You have to engage in more service. You have to do service. Just crying all the time is not going to do you any good.
应当从事服务，而不是在那里一个劲儿的哭流泪，这不能给你带来很多好处。 下一个问题是生命之花，顶拜Guru。 生病了很难受，每天需要睡十几个小时，做不了服务，什么服务？天冷也很难早起，这怎么克服愚昧心态？需要顾着仁慈。 So Guru, when I'm sick, I'm uncomfortable. I need to sleep more than 10 hours a day and cannot do any service, and also when the temperature is cold, I cannot get up very early. So how can I overcome the mode of ignorance? I need Guru's mercy.
You are very difficult. You're in the mode of ignorance. I don't know. You need to have more enthusiasm to overcome this ignorance. You have to have more determination and enthusiasm to try to stop sleeping so much. And So you have to have more desire to want to get out of the mode of ignorance.
你要需要有更多的想要克 克服愚昧形态，摆脱愚昧形态的愿望心愿。
So we'll pray for you.
我们为你祈祷。
Okay.
当心呢，说顶戴顾客翻译近两年没吃肉，也不想吃。昨天晚上梦到肉了，竟然还动了心思想吃一口，然后制止了自己。这是心意的作用还是潜意识呢？感恩您。I have been vegetarian for two years. But yesterday I dreamed about the meat, and I even want to eat, and then I stop myself. So is it the effect of the mind or the subconsciousness?
Well, it's not much difference between the mind and subconsciousness. You could say it's subconsciousness because you had associated, you've only been a vegetarian 2 years. So you still have some thought. These things come in the mind from the subconsciousness. You have to preach to your mind. You have to explain to your mind how meat eating is not encouraged, how meat eating is a mode of ignorance, and how you want to leave it behind you, finish, you don't eat meat anymore, and you want to get away from it. So if you're determined, then you'll forget this. And sometimes Prabhupada would say, sometimes Krishna is arranging these things to tell you that if you ever give up being a devotee, then you have to go back to that kind of life again, meat eating, the mode of ignorance.
帕帕都说过，这也是 Krishna 安排，就告诉我们说，如果我们不去做奉献者，那我们就会回到肉食这件事儿，回到愚昧形态。聆听 Sangita， 举手。
阿里维什纳，听到了吗？
听到。
顶
拜咕噜，顶拜所有的奉献者。我是桑给他，就是我关于就是今天这位老咕噜讲这个在家的这个修行，在灵修上这个，我感觉到在家的灵修确实是很困难，就是因为这奉献者也少，联谊也很少，联谊一个人在家就是灵修上很难这个提升。现在就是有一个奉献者，联系要去巴马具体灵修，我想请问咕噜，我有心想去，不知道，不是我自己还拿不定主意，因为就是这个，因为我都80多岁了嘛，那个，有一个邻居就是像姑娘一样似的，就是。待着帮助我这个什么那个，反正他在跟我一起吃啊什么的，反正他都也不反对，但是在灵修上他还不太感兴趣。我先把他拉进来，他还不太感兴趣。我是就是一个人，就这样下去灵修上也很难进步。我是去巴马跟那个组团，他们要联系具体去上这灵修， 我有心是去，但是我自己拿不定主意，请咕噜给我指示。感谢咕噜，顶拜咕噜。
No, to Burma. No, if you go to Burma, are you going to get good association there? You think there are devotees there?
如果您去巴马的话，您可能得到很好的联谊吗？那里有奉献者吗？
就是也刚有一个人在这个，就是在网上发的，说是谁要去就和他联系。我也不了解这个奉献者是哪儿的，我没跟他联系呢，我只是有这么点想法。
And you're going to go so far away to go all the way to Burma, you don't even know what kind of association you're going to get. I think it's quite risky to go.
您千里迢迢的去到
不能是确定这么那啥，到那儿很不知道什么情况。
对。
不到这
里。So you better just stay where you are. You're not a young lady. You're in old age. You go all the way down there on your own. It's not a very good idea.
就是你还最好还是，留在你现在的地方。因为您已经不是年轻人了，已经上了岁数了，所以如果您一个人，这么去那里，这不是特别的，这不是特别的好，不是一个好主意。
感恩咕噜，是就得听咕噜的话，咕噜可能有，要不然我自己。还没有主意，谢谢咕噜，顶拜咕噜。
OK， 顶拜Sangita Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
The last question， 菲尔，顶拜咕噜，一个奉献者必须熟读各经典书籍才有资格回灵性世界吗 ？Whether a devotee should be should learn all kind of scriptures, then can have the qualification to go back to spiritual world.
No, that's not the qualification to go back to the spiritual world. Qualification to go back to the spiritual world is that you have love for Krishna.
回归灵性世界的资格是你对 Krishna 有爱。
You may have a lot of knowledge, you may read all the scriptures and so on, but you may not have any real love for Krishna, and you may still have a lot of material desires.
你可能熟读了各种经典，也很有知识，但却没有爱，也许还有很多的物质欲望。
So you have to be free of material desires as well to go back to Krishna.
要想回到 Krishna 那里，还要摆脱物质欲望。
You have to want to serve Krishna.
你必须要想要服务 Krishna.
And sometimes people read a lot of books. They just want to be a big scholar.
有的人。他们就读很多书，就是想当大学者。
Well, they have a lot. They've read so many books. They have so much knowledge, but they may not have attachment to Krishna.
他们也许读了很多书，有很多知识，但是没有对 Krishna 有依附，依恋 Krishna。
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Okay. That's all the question.
Okay, well, my Ganshya Guru Mani, Gewaman, Fan E, Ganshya Panmamukhi, Georgia, Ganshya Soyuda Functions and LinkedIn. 我们祝福你们传教顺利，唱诵快乐 Hare Krishna Srila Prabhupada Ki
在外昆塔知音服务员聆听，我非常非常感谢圣宝帖 为大师的辛哈马尔。